Hi children, after your Diwali vacation, let's start our online sessions from today onwards. I welcome you all for the today's English class. Today in our English class, we are going to see the next chapter in our grammar unit, chapter 7, tenses. Tenses are otherwise called as verb tenses, because it completely depends on the verbs. First of all, let's see what is meant by tenses. The word tense comes from the Latin word tempus, which means time. So, tenses denotes the time of action of the verb. So children, tense is a word that was derived from a Latin word tempus, which means time. So tense denotes the time of the action of the verb. Then what is meant by verb, children? That we already know that verbs are the words that describe an action, an occurrence, or a state of being. That is known as verb. So, as I already told you children, the word tense is derived from the Latin word tempus, which means time. So, tense is a form of verb. Tense is a form of verb which used to express the action when it takes place. That is, when an action is, was, or will be performed. Express when an action is, was, or will be performed based on the time frame. That is, when the action is taking place, we can divide or categorize tenses into three types. First one is present tense, second one is past tense, and the third one is future tense. Now children, let's watch a video about these three tenses within examples. Hello children, do you want to improve your English? We all know that we need to improve our roots and good fruits. Children, to get good fruits of English, we are now going to learn the root of English. That is, we're going to learn tenses today. These are the main fundamental pillar for both speaking and writing correct English. You must learn that properly. What exactly is a tense? Tense is a form of a verb that takes to show the time it happened. It actually describes when any action that happened with respect to its time. Now children, the time of the action could be in past, present, or in future. Children, look at the timeline carefully. The circle represents the present tense. Here, the line which is left to the circle is the time which is already passed, and the line which is right to the circle is the future time. So please understand this timeline properly, children, because as we are going to use this timeline for understanding when any action took place with respect to time, as the time could be past, present, or future. Tenses are mainly divided into three types: past tense, present tense, and future tense. Now, each of these three types have four subtypes. First one is simple, second one is continuous, third one is perfect, fourth one is perfect continuous. Consider this as a family tree, children. The grandfather tense is having three children: past, present, and future. And each parent is having four sons with same name, that is simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. Writing them all becomes 12 siblings. That means 12 tenses. We are going to learn each of them. For that, we need to know forms of verbs, which are mainly divided into 5 forms, which are: base form, we will denote it as V1. Then past form, we will denote it as V2. then past participle form will denote it as B3. Then S or ES form will denote it as V S or ES. Then ING form will denote it as V ING. Let's see an example for the verb play. The base form of the verb is play. The past form of the verb is played. And the past participle form is played. S or ES form is plays. And then ING form is playing. Let's see one more example with the verb go. The base form of the verb is go and the past form is went. Past participle form is gone. S or ES form is goes. And finally the ING form is going. So children, now I think you must be clear about the verb forms. Let's see and move on to the tenses.
Children, as I explained you with the family tree, in English we have 12 tenses. Tense is the grandfather. For the grandfather, it has 3 children. First one is present tense, second one is past tense, and third one is future tense. So each parent has its own children in the same name, present simple, present continuous, present perfect continuous. Coming to the second son, past simple, past continuous, past perfect, and past perfect continuous. These are the children. Then for the son of future, which has the same children, that is simple future, future continuous, future perfect, and future perfect continuous.
Children, in this session we are going to see the parents, that is simple present, simple past, and simple future. All the simple tenses we are going to see in this session. Simple present tense, that refers to any action that occurs on regular basis or any facts that stands true all times. The sentence structure, that is the sentence pattern, is subject verb 1 plus object. Let's see an example for present tense for regular action. I play football regularly. In this sentence we can see that I am doing an activity of playing on regular basis from the past till now. And in the future also, I will continue. Let's see another example for fact. Sun rises in the east. It is a truth based on the fact that sun rises only in the east. No one can change it and challenge it. So it is an example for simple present tense.
Let's see the timeline. Wherever the action occurs, we can say that the action was happening in the past, is happening now, and will continue in the future. An important note, children, in case of third person singular form of verbs, verb plus S, ES form is used. For example, in case of third person Ram, it will be Ram plays football regularly.
Children, let's see in detail about the first tense, that is simple present tense. In simple present tense, we have to use the be form of verbs such as am, is, and are, and do form of verbs such as do and does.
Children, what is mean by simple present tense? A simple present tense that express an action in the present time, habitual actions, or general truths. For example, look at the example first one, that express the action in a habitual way. Habitual means regular routine, that is known as habitual. Children, Prabhu walks to school every day. It is a habitual, that is regular activity. Then look at the next example that expresses the general truth. The sun rises in the east. So it is a general truth. We cannot change it. It is a general fact. Then look at the next example, expresses action in general time. That is, I work in a factory. It is a general action that expresses the general time. It is, that is
Now it is happening. So in the present. So in simple present tense, we can express other actions that can be habitual, that is regular routine, or it can be about any general truth or facts. So to express the action, whether it is a habitual, that is regular routine, or to express the general truth and to express the regular time. So we need to use the simple present tense, children. So simple present tense is the tense that used to express the present time, habitual actions, or for general truth. Children, after the definition, let's see the verb form of simple present tense. In simple present tense, we have to use the base form of verbs only. So look at the picture, children. First, in the beginning, you can see the base form of the tenses, that is go, let, swim, sing, travel, watch, dance, etc. These are the verbs that are the actions that represents the simple present tense that should be in the base form, that is V1, children. And very important note, in the case of third person, we have to add S or ES at the end of the verb. For example, go, goes, let, lets, swim, swims, sing, sings, travel, travels, watch, watches, dance, dances. So like this, you have to use the verbs in, if it is the third person, you have to add S or ES along with the verb, children, in the present tense. So after the verb form, let's see the pattern. In simple present tense, we can express the habitual action, general truth, fact, and daily activities, children. Look at the pattern here. For positive, we can use subject, verb 1, that is the base form, S or ES plus object. If it is negative, you have to use subject, do or does not, verb 1 plus object. If it is interrogative, do or does with the subject, verb 1, that is the base form, and object. So see here, the do form of verb must be used with the subject I, you, we, they, and does must be used with the subject he, she, and it, children. So do must be used with I, you, we, they. Does has to be used with he, she, it. Children, that's all from the pattern. Let's see the positive, negative, and interrogative sentences in simple present tense. Children, look at the tabulation carefully. Here we have be form of verbs, and we are going to learn how to make positive, negative, and interrogative sentences in simple present tense. First, see here, singular. I, you, he, she, it. These are all singular subjects. See here, I must be used with am. So the sentence is, I am happy. Then the next one, you are at school. Then he is hungry. She is a nurse. It is big. So these are all positive sentences. Look at the negative sentences for the same. I am not sad. I am not sad. Then you aren't at home. That means int means it is not. So you aren't at home. He isn't thirsty. She isn't a pilot. It isn't. Opposite to it, you can see the negative sentences. We aren't late. You aren't teachers. They aren't noisy. Okay. So you have seen both singular and plural form, both in affirmative and negative sentences, children, in simple present tense. Look at the question formation here, affirmative. In positive, they are happy. How to change it into question, are they happy? Yes, they are happy. No, they aren't. Then next one, is she rich? She is rich.
Is she rich? Yes, she is. No, she isn't. So these are the conversion of question interrogative sentences from affirmative, and they are yes or no short answers also, that is question tags also. So this is the way you need to make sentences using the simple present tense children in positive, negative and question formation small. So these are all negative for the same sentences. This is the singular form of sentences. Look at the plural form here. We are early, it is in the plural form. You are students, they are quiet. These are all for positive. Children, look at the picture given here. Use of is, am, are. These are the helping verbs that we are using in the simple present tense. I must be used with am. You must be used with are. Others, such as, that is for singular subjects like he, she, it, we have to use is. And for plural subjects like you, we, they, we need to use are. Let's see some examples for the be form of verbs in simple present tense. He is an English teacher. In other verbs in common, he teaches English. Here, I am an English teacher. I teach English. They are English teachers. In other verbs, they teach English. We use is, am, are rules, and we sometimes use yes with verbs. So children, that's all from the simple present tense. In simple present tense, we have seen the definition, pattern, rules, verbs, forms of simple present tense along with the examples. Let's move on to the next tense, that is simple past tense. Simple past tense, it refers to an action that is completed before the time that we are talking about it. The sentence structure and the pattern for past tense is subject V2 plus object. For example, I played football yesterday. Here we are referring to an action of playing football that is already completed in the past. So look at the timeline. Here you can see the left of the timeline, that is denoting that the action is completed in the past. Children, let's see the simple past tense in detail now. Look at the picture. You have the verbs walk, eat. See the verb to form, that is the past tense form, past form, verb to form. Walk, walked, eat, ate. Walk and walked are the example for regular verb. Eat and ate is the example for irregular verbs. Children, in simple past tense, we have to use verb to form of the verb only. Children, in simple past tense, we have to use the do form, that is did, to make the questions as well as to make the negative statements. First of all, what is mean by simple past tense, children? See here, simple past tense is used to indicate those action which began in the past time and also got over in the past time. So children, in simple past tense, the action that began in the past time and also got over in the past itself, then it is known as simple past tense. The pattern for simple past tense is subject verb 2, that is verb along with ed, that is regular verb. If it is defer, then it is known as irregular verbs. Children, look at the pattern for the simple past tense. So see here, subject verb 2 plus object. So for example, the child played, children played. So we are using only the verb 2 of the verb in the simple past tense. In simple past tense, we need to use the be form of verbs in the affirmative sentence, that is the positive sentence,
that was given here for singular, I, you, he, she, it. For I, we need to use was. For you need to use were. Be form of verb, were. For singular subject, he, she, it, we need to use was. For in the plural form, for you, we, they, we need to use only were. So this is the be form of verb that we need to use in the simple past tense in the affirmative sentences. Children, in simple past tense we have two kinds of verbs, that is regular verbs, another one is irregular verbs. What is meant by regular verbs? Regular verbs are the verbs that are used usually add and ends with ed in the along with the action word, that is verbs. So look at the example given here. Listen, listened, looked, painted, played. These are the example for regular verbs, children. Regular verb means adding ed along with the verb, that is regular verbs. What is meant by irregular verbs? Completely differ in the past tense form. See here, look at the example for irregular verbs. See here, it won't end with, it will not end with the ed form. So see here, don't end with ed. Have a vowel change in the past tense. See here, simple form is become. The past tense form is became. Then look at the next one. Simple form is give and the past tense form is gave. It is differing in the vowel. So have a vowel change in the past tense. The next one, drive, drove, forget, forgot. So these are the examples for irregular verbs, children, in simple past tense. See the example for the affirmative, negative and question sentences for simple past tense, children. So look at the tabulation here. In positive, I worked. In negative, I didn't work. In question tag, in question form, did I work? The next one, you worked, you didn't work, did you work? We worked, we didn't work, did we work? They worked, they didn't work, did they work? She worked, she didn't work, did she work? Then, he worked, he didn't work, did he work? Then in positive, it worked. In negative, it didn't work. In question, did it work? So we need to use did form in the negative and the question form to make question negative and question sentence. And we verb to must be used in the past tense form. So this is the simple past tense, children.
Simple future tense. It refers to an action which will happen or occur in future. The structure and the pattern of simple future tense is subject plus will plus verb 1 plus object. For example, I will play football tomorrow. Here, the referring action that will happen tomorrow. Look at the timeline here. Future was in the right side of the timeline to denote that the action will happen in future. Let's see about the simple future tense in detail now. What is future tense? The future tense is a verb tense used to talk about something that will happen or will be true in the future. For example, he'll be here soon. I'll give you a call. What will you do? It will be sunny tomorrow. So, a simple future tense is a verb tense that is used to talk about something that will happen in the future. Let's see the formula and the sentence pattern for simple future tense. So look at here, children, for positive sentence, that is for affirmative, we have to start with subject plus will or shall plus verb.
verb should be in the base form. That is verb 1. So look at the negative sentence and the sentence pattern here. Subject plus will or shall not plus base form. That is verb 1. So this is the negative form and the sentence pattern. Next, let's see for the interrogative sentence. So see the sentence pattern here. Will plus subject plus the base form of the verb with the question mark. Look at the example that was given here for the positive, that is affirmative sentence below the pattern. I will go to Thailand. Look at the negative. I will not go to Thailand. Look at the interrogative sentence. Will you go to Thailand? So these are the positive, negative and the interrogative sentences for simple future tense. So look at the example for will and going to. So we can use for simple future tense both will and going to. Look at the example sentence for will. I will travel to Japan next year. So will is used to mention, denote the decision. And moving on to the example for going to. See the sentence here. I am going to study German at school. So here the usage of the word going to is about the plan. So for simple future tense, we can use both will and going to express the decision and plan that was going to be happen in future. Look at the usage of will form in the sentences like positive, negative and interrogative sentences. First, look at the affirmative sentence. I will travel to Madrid in October. I will travel to Madrid in October. Then look at the interrogative sentence in future tense using the will form. Will you travel by bus? Will you travel by bus? Then the negative form. I will not travel or I won't travel. This is the negative form. So in simple future tense, the will form with positive, negative and interrogative sentences here. Will you travel by train or by bus? I won't travel by bus. I will probably travel by train. So now uses of will. First one, will is used to mention or denote instant decisions. Okay, I will see you on Friday. So this is the example for instant decision. The second use of will is predictions based in what we think. So look at the example given here. It will rain in the evening. Then the third usage of will is promises and offers. So look at the example here. Don't worry, I will go and buy some food for you. So to express the promises and offers, we can use the will form in the future tense. So will is the word that is used to express instant decisions, predictions based in what we think, and promises and offers. So will is a verb that we can use in the simple future tense. So children, in this session we have discussed and learned about the simple tenses, that is simple present, simple past and simple future tenses. Children, let's review and recap the tenses that we discussed today, that is simple present, past and future. So simple present tense is a tense that we can express the event which is happening now. For example, I am looking for bugs in the park. Then for past tense, the event that has already happened. Past tense are the tense that is used to represent the event that had already happened. For example, I looked at bugs in the park. Then the next one is future tense. Is the tense that is used to represent the event is going to happen. That is event going to happen. For example, in this today's session, children.
So I think now you must be clear about these three simple tenses, that is present, past and future.
I will look for box tomorrow. So these are the tenses we have discussed
in today's session, children. So I think now you must be clear about the simple tenses, that is simple present, simple past and simple future.